Good morning and welcome to Messiah Lutheran Church's daily devotions based on the lectionary. My name is Traci and I'm the Director of Faith Formation here at Messiah. And today I get to share with you one of the most beloved and beautiful Psalms, Psalm 8. It reads, O Lord, our Lord, how majestic is your name in all the earth. You whose glory is chanted above the heavens out of the mouths of infants and children. You have set up a fortress against your enemies to silence the foe and avenger. When I consider your heavens, the work of your fingers, the moon and the stars you have set in their courses, what are mere mortals that you should be mindful of them, human beings that you should care for them? Yet you have made them little less than divine. With glory and honor, you crown them. You have made them rule over the works of your hands. You have put all things under their feet, all flocks and cattle, even the wild beasts of the field, the birds of the air, the fish of the sea, and whatever passes along the paths of the sea. O Lord, our Lord, how majestic is your name in all the earth. I love this psalm, especially the words, when I consider your heavens, the work of your fingers, the moon and the stars you have set in their courses, who are we? The Message version of this reads, I look up at your macro skies, dark and enormous, your handmade sky jewelry, moon and stars mounted in their settings. Then I look at my micro self and wonder, why do you bother with us? Why take a second look our way? I think about David gazing out at the night sky as he penned these words. Experts say that he could probably see about 5,000 stars at that period of time. Today, with a 4-inch telescope, a person could probably see about 2 million stars. And bigger telescopes can see more than 1 billion stars. Psalm 8 has the distinction of being the first biblical text to reach the moon. It was brought there in 1969 on the first manned landing by Apollo 11. Now, David didn't know all those facts, but he still marveled when he gazed at the night sky. And like David, I marvel when I gaze at the night sky. And like David, when I get a glimpse of the vastness of God's creation, it overwhelms me. The psalm always brings to mind for me the hymn, How Great Thou Art, whose first verse reads, O Lord my God, when I in awesome wonder consider all the world thy hands have made, I see the stars, I hear the mighty thunder, thy power throughout the universe displayed. The writer of this hymn was a Lutheran pastor. He's a preacher, poet, and editor, and his name was Carl Gustav Boberg. And the story goes that in 1885, he was walking home, and a huge thunderstorm appeared on the horizon. Lightning flashed, and thunder shook the air, and it sent Boberg running for shelter. When the storm began to relent, he rushed home, and he opened his windows to let in the fresh air. And the vision of calmness and tranquility that greeted him stirred something deep within his soul. The sky had cleared, birds sang, and in the distance, church bells rang in the background. The juxtaposition between the roaring thunderstorm and such deep calm right then caused Boberg to sit down and write a poem that, through a series of winding events, would become How Great Thou Art. After the poem was published, it didn't really catch on, and it seemed destined to be forgotten. But 3 years later, someone out there liked it well enough to match the words with a traditional Swedish melody. And when Boberg found out about that, he quickly republished the poem once again in his own newspaper, this time with the musical notation added. So fast forward a few decades to the 1930s, and somehow this poem put to music had traveled across borders. An English missionary, Stuart Hine, heard the song in Russian while he was in Poland, and he was deeply moved, and he translated it into English, and he took it home with him to England. And the song was now called How Great Thou Art. In the 1940s, an evangelist heard the new version of the song. He heard it in India, and he was deeply inspired by it, and he brought the song back to the United States. In 1954, the song found its way into the hands of George Beverly Shea, who sang it nearly 100 times during Billy Graham's 1957 New York Crusade. In 1959, it became the theme song for Billy Graham's weekly radio broadcast, and that brought How Great Thou Art into national consciousness. Since then, Elvis, Tennessee Ernie Ford, Loretta Lynn, Carrie Underwood, Vince Gill are among the many performers who have recorded it. In 1978, the song was named the all-time greatest outstanding gospel song in America, and it has consistently been listed as one of the greatest hymns ever written, usually falling at number two, right behind Amazing Grace. On a more personal note, my parents both loved this hymn, so every time I hear it, I think of them. It was one of the hymns played at my sister Beth's funeral, and my mom's funeral, and my dad's funeral. The other day, I asked some dear friends here at Messiah if they would sing it for me, and they agreed, and the final product brought me both chills and tears. I hope that you'll enjoy it.
I'm Thank you.